De regreso aquí en Auto 060, seguimos en el Amelia Island Concours d'Elegance y ahora pasamos a hablar con BMW, una de las firmas que siempre está presente en este festival de autos clásicos y modernos, y para eso vamos a tener la otra entrevista más que realizó Camilo allá con BMW en Amelia Island Concours d'Elegance.
Hola Javier, we're here at Amelia Island for the Concours d'Elegance and we're here with a very special guest, Thomas Plasinski, Director of Communications for BMW. Hi Tom.
Hi Camilo, how are you?
Pretty good, pretty good. What a beautiful day it is here, Amelia.
Yes, it's really wonderful. This is a great event. We love this one here. It's, you know, it's about 300 of the best cars you could imagine. I think we have a sellout crowd today. You can't get around even. And we come every year and we try to bring a few really special cars with us to show to the fans.
Now, speaking of special cars, I mean, I'm here looking at your display, and it is very impressive. Can you tell us a little bit about the models here?
Exactly. Well, Amelia Island this year asked for a grouping of CSLs, which was a car that was built in the early to mid-70s, and they asked us for one of our art cars, and it turns out that the very first BMW art car done by Alexander Calder was a 3.0 CSL race car that raced at Le Mans in 1975. And then behind us is a grouping of other CSLs, three very, very important racing CSLs that really put BMW on the map in the U.S. in the early days of being a brand in America. The number 25 that we have here won Sebring in March of 1975, so that's 39 years ago, almost 39 years ago today, in fact. And it's a car that people come up to and they go, oh, I always loved this car. I was always rooting for this car. I'm glad to see it again. You know, we've had people take their pictures with the car that were kids when they first had their picture taken with the car, and they're back here today to as grown-ups having their picture taken again. It's wonderful.
You know, this is so impressive to see, we're here and I'm looking directly at a 3.0 CSL that's owned by racing legend Bobby Rahal.
Yes, exactly. Bobby is a big fan of the brand. He runs our race team for us right now, but he also has a collection of very special BMWs from our history. Here we have his 3.0 CSL that he restored a couple years ago. It's his daily driver. This is one of the cars he drives all the time. Not in the winter, of course, but in the summer, this is what he likes to drive. He has a few other cars as well. So over the years, as we come to Amelia, you might see one or two other of his cars.
One of the cars that I believe is it David Hobbs? Yes,
David Hobbs. Yes,
racing legend as well.
Right.
I think it's a 320.
Exactly. Yes. David raced for us for about 10 years in various types of cars, and the featured mark this year is McLaren. And most people don't really know, but in the late 70s, 1977 to be exact, McLaren Engineering in the U.S. was the team for BMW, so they were the ones that operated the race cars, and they built this 320 Turbo that was a very forward-thinking car. It was the very first turbo race car in BMW's history, and they did a lot of experimentation with turbocharging, and were able to get roughly 750 horsepower out of a 2-liter four-cylinder engine.
And most people don't know that this engine actually was one of the engines that led to an F1.
Exactly. So that engine, this was the beginning of its development in 1977, and then over the years it was developed even more, and its crowning victory was winning the Formula One championship in 1983. And at that point, the engine developed in qualifying trim, it developed a roughly 1,500 horsepower out of a 2-liter engine.
Wow, that is amazing to see that type of power of an engine. Well, Thomas, thank you so much for being on the show with us today. And I see that you have a couple ribbons on your CSLs here.
Yes, I think we did okay today. We're waiting to see if we won the class, and we'll take the number 25 Sebring winning car for our drive up to the podium to receive the award, hopefully. So we're waiting with crossed fingers and bated breath.
Can I take that ride with you?
I think you could, yeah.
Thank you so much, Tom.
You're very welcome.
All right, take care.
Gracias Camilo y gracias a Tom Prusinski del grupo BMW por esa información, toda la entrevista allá en Amelia Island Concours d'Elegance, súper interesante como siempre.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.